I am going to divide this video into three different parts, because Edmund Barton was an influential man in three distinct areas. He was a Federalist, he was the first Prime Minister, and he was a Justice of the High Court. The bloke could do it all. Hello everyone, my name is Renato Costa, this is Aussie Law, and today we are going to navigate through the life of the first Prime Minister of Australia, a former Justice of the High Court, a Federalist. I'm talking about Toby Tosspot, I mean Edmund Barton. Edmund Barton was born in 1849 in Sydney, Australia. After completing his master's degree, he qualified as a barrister in 1871. In 1879, he successfully contested a seat for the New South Wales Legislative Assembly. He was 30 years old. And just 3 years later, at the age of 33, Barton was the youngest ever presiding officer in an Australian legislature. So let's start talking specifically about the three feuds in his life. Let's start with Barton, the Federalist. It was during his years as a representative of the New South Wales Assembly that Edmund Barton met and later on was directly influenced by Sir Henry Parkes. In the video I made about Sir Henry Parkes, I said that his speech at Tinterfield in 1889 changed the life of Sir Edmund Barton. It really did, because it was after that speech that Barton started to go all around Australia to all the colonies, spreading the idea of federation. He shifted his focus from the state affairs to now a real cause, the cause of federalism. And we can see the influence of Parkes in Barton's political life, not only because of the speech and the fact that later on Barton started going to all of the colonies in Australia to proclaim and talk about this cause of federation, but also because there were some correspondences between Parkes and Barton that revealed to us the relationship between the two. They constantly talked about the works of the New South Wales Legislative Assembly, and also they did create strategies coordinating the ways in which they could make the cause of federation more real in Australia. This book here brings a lot of correspondences, and it reveals the relationship really between Barton and Parkes. That relationship changed a bit in 1893 though, when Barton changed his allegiance from the Free Trade Party, the party that was the party of Sir Henry Parkes, to the Protectionist Party. What Henry Parkes' party wanted, the Free Traders, they wanted for all the manufacturing goods that were produced in the UK, they could be imported and commercialized in Australia freely. But the Protectionist Party, the one that Barton was now part of, they wanted to make sure that the manufacturing industries in Australia would prosper. And by doing that, they wanted to impose some duties in the importation of products coming from overseas, or even maybe even forbidding them completely. And in the video that I'd made about Henry Parkes, I said that this was one of the main topics for Parkes. He really wanted trade to be free. Despite that friction in their relationship, both of them were really aligned in matters of federation. We could see that even after Henry Parkes' death in 1896, Edmund Barton continued the cause of federation in Australia. He really wanted to see a federal Australia. He was such a defender of that cause that in the first federal convention in 1891 in Sydney, he was a member of the Constitutional Committee. He also led the sittings of the federal conventions in 1897 and 98. And he also played a major role in supporting the Constitution in the referendum in 1899. Barton was such an important character for the Australian Federation that he was one of the members who travelled to England to see the passing of the bill, was later to become the Commonwealth of Australia Constitution Act, by the Westminster Parliament in the 1900s. If you want to know more about that context, I invite you to watch our first video about the Commonwealth of Australia Constitution Act. By the way, funny but interesting story, Barton almost missed the trip to England. As the story goes, Barton was at a supper at a refreshments room and he missed the train from Mossvale to Sydney, and the train had to come back to pick him up so that he could join the others in Sydney to travel to England. Well, the trip went well, and in January 1901, we had a constitution, and Barton was to become the first Australian Prime Minister. So this is the second part of the video. Edmund Barton as a Prime Minister. Although, he almost didn't make it either. Maybe by mistake, maybe not. The newly appointed Governor General of Australia, Lord Hopetoun, he appointed Sir William Lyne, the Premier of New South Wales, as the first Prime Minister. Now, there's a bunch of issue with that, because Lyne was actually an anti-federalist. He was opposing Edmund Barton in everything that Barton defended. Despite that fact, Lyne actually invited Barton to be part of his cabinet and form his government. But Barton didn't accept it. By the way, he actually said that it would be a contradiction for him to accept it because, and here I quote, he would be serving under the Prime Minister who opposed the adoption by the people of the measure of which he is now asked to be the first constitutional guardian. But in the end, Lyne was unable to form a government, so Barton took his post, and at the age of 52, he became Australia's first Prime Minister. Barton's government was really important. Think about it, that was the first government of the new federation. So during his time, we saw a lot of important policies. Some of them weren't that good. That's the case of the Immigration Act. The Immigration Restriction Act intended to create a white Australian policy. That didn't work. But where there's the bad, there's also the good. So there are some really good things happening in his government as well. For example, women were now able to vote in a federal election. There was also the development of a transcontinental railway coming from the east to the west. And he also laid down the foundations for the creation of the High Court of Australia, which happened in 1903. And it was during that time that Barton's nickname really caught up. He was also known as Toby Tosspot. That nickname was given to him by The Bulletin, a newspaper of the time, because he was fond of going to the club and he liked to live the good life. In fact, the editor of the Sydney Bulletin, J.F. Archibald, he was a member of the Athenian Club, the same club that Barton used to go to. So I guess we know who to blame for that nickname, don't we? Yeah, we do. And if you don't know what Tosspot means, as I didn't before researching for this video, it just means someone who likes to have the certain amount of alcoholic beverages with a certain constancy. That's it. Barton was one of the three prime ministers in Australian history that chose to retire at their own time. The other two were Fisher and Menzies. And he chose to retire, some people say, because his popularity was already in decline, especially because he spent six consecutive months doing work in England. And at that time, the person who was really ruling, governing Australia, was Sir Alfred Deakin, who was to become the second Prime Minister of Australia. So in September 1903, Edmund Barton retired as a Prime Minister. But he didn't stop his political life there. Now, he was to become a judge sitting at the High Court of Australia. So this is the third part of the video. Sir Edmund Barton, now Justice of the High Court. Some people say that it was quite surprising that Barton didn't choose himself as the first Chief Justice of the High Court. But he had a real high regard for Sir Samuel Griffith, who he considered to be the best lawyer of the Commonwealth, and that's why he appointed Griffith as the Chief Justice. So in the original formation of the High Court of Australia, we have Chief Justice Samuel Griffith, we have Barton and O'Connor sitting as the other two justices, so only three justices in the High Court. And by the way, Richard O'Connor was not only a Federalist, but he was also a childhood friend from Barton's. Barton ended up being the Justice of the High Court for 16 years. And during that time, he obviously decided a bunch of very important cases. I'm obviously not going to go through all of them, but he was an important justice in the High Court of Australia. And he sat at the bench of the High Court as a High Court Justice until his death. That occurred in January 1920, when he was about to turn 71. At the time of Edmund Barton's death, he was described as Australia's noblest son. I hope you liked this video and the video about Henry Parkes as well. If you did, don't forget to like it, to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell sign. And of course, share this with your friends and family so you can show them that you know a lot about Henry Parkes and about Edmund Barton. And I'll see you next week. Until then, ciao.